Co-hosts of the popular long-running show MythBusters died suddenly. 49-year-old Grant Imahara died from a brain aneurysm. Imahara had become a popular figure since joining the science show back in its third season, and his sudden death caught many of his former co-hosts by surprise.
Joining us right now to talk about the rise of brain aneurysms is Dr. Demetrius Lopes, the director of the Advocate Healthcare Stroke Program. Thank you, doctor, for joining us. We appreciate it today. Many times you hear about brain aneurysms happening in someone's sleep or it came on suddenly. Does that happen, or are there symptoms prior to?
A majority of times it's a surprise. The symptoms that is most common is usually a sudden headache, and it's usually the worst headache of your life. But the majority of aneurysms may present without any warning symptoms.
And doctor, how often do we see a 49-year-old get a brain aneurysm, and what are people supposed to do?
Well, this is actually the peak age. You know, it's usually after the 40s, up to 60 years old, the most common time. Even children can have aneurysms. But this is not uncommon to see in the most productive time of our lives. Best thing to do, avoid smoking, control your blood pressure. If you have a family history of brain aneurysms, have checked. The best thing to do would be image of the brain, such as a CT angiogram or the MR angiogram.
You say that it comes on suddenly, it's usually a surprise, and not to smoke and things like that. So are you saying it cannot be prevented, or it can be prevented? I'm a little confused.
Yeah, no, it's definitely something that cannot be prevented. I think that it's usually something that if you catch on a screening, you have an possibility to discuss a treatment prior to rupture of an aneurysm.
Right, not a lot of people are getting screened, though, for it.
Absolutely. It's definitely recommended if you have a family history of aneurysms. But otherwise, we tend to keep a healthy lifestyle with avoiding smoking and controlling blood pressure. These are probably the most important recommendations that we can have to prevent aneurysms to grow and rupture.
So there are, it's my understanding, procedures to avoid bleeding in the brain. How does that work?
Absolutely. So if you detect an aneurysm, or even if the aneurysm has ruptured, mind you, 15% of people may not even arrive to the hospital. They may pass before getting to the hospital, and there may be a 50% mortality of the rupture of the aneurysm. So if you catch the aneurysm before it ruptures, or if you survive a rupture of an aneurysm, we're able to go and we have many techniques to repair these aneurysms today and avoid it from rupturing again, or potentially saving somebody's life by blocking the blood flow going to the aneurysm, either by an endovascular procedure or by open brain surgery.
So be careful if you have a family history of it. Be checked, get some images, and lead a healthy lifestyle. Dr. Demetrius Lopes, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Be safe, be well.